So hello everyone, my name is MJ Han, and this presentation is about integrating linked open data into libraries' digitized special collections. The motivation behind our project is that while there are several very key and important active national and international collaborative projects for linked open data for libraries' traditional data, less attention has been given to specialized digitized collections that we really care for. So, University of Illinois and Urbana-Champaign Library has been looking at working with digitized special collections for the last 18 months. So, we would like to share what kind of things that we have done in terms of publishing our specialized metadata for digitized special collections to linked data, and what kind of services that we implemented with linked data. So, first about the project. Our project is trying to explore the benefits for users of linked open data for digitized special collections. And it is an 18-month exploratory study funded by, again, Andrew W. Mellon Foundation. And we try to look at the digitized libraries' special collections because many relegated to information silos, largely disconnected from the broader web. So everything is very special. So we actually don't try to make it available on the web or try connect with other resources available on the web. So we are wondering, how can we better connect these special resources to the web? And can we use linked open data to help us? And if so, how hard it should be, it can be. So our objectives include mapping legacy metadata that we currently in our digital asset management system into linked open data compliant schemas, and actively link to and from, not just making out, but bring into our systems. For example, DBpedia, VIAF, Wikipedia, and other related web resources. And the collections that we tested are three. So first one is the Motley Collection of Theater and Costume Design that has more than 500 images of costume and set designs and productions and so on that actually represent a variety of objects from the Motley Group's career that spans from 1932 to 1976. And the second one is Portrait of Actors, 1720 to 1920, that has around 3,500 pictures of actors that I actually don't know, but if you are theater buff, that you may recognize a few of those faces. And the third one is Cole Proust Archives for Research. This is text-based collection, and that has 8,700 of Professor Philip Cole's research note card on Marcel Proust. And the card was categorized in two different files. One is a chronology of events concerning Proust's life, and the other one is a bibliography of works mentioned in Proust correspondences. We chose these three collections because we thought that this has the best metadata among our digitized special collections. So we kind of hope that we have a less problem to working with this metadata, but you will see. And then we chose schema.org as a vehicle for discovery because of these five reasons when we choose to use schema.org in 18 months ago. So it is because it is industry-wide use by web search engines, we recognize that there is a changes nowadays, but at the time, it was the thing that schema.org is the one that all the major web search engines are using. And some promising schemas, for example, or notably BibFrame 2.0, were still under development at the time. And some existing schemas were considered too heavyweight for our project data and objectives. And again, also some existing schemas did not have widespread adoptions for we would like to follow. So we settled to schema.org because we were able to reuse previous library-oriented project. Both happened in our University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign as well as OCLC that utilize schema.org as is the linked open data schema. So our three collections can be divided into two groups. One is image-based theater collections, and the other one is text collection. And we decided to work with the image collection first because we thought that it is very easy and simple. So we would like to cross out that collection first, but it is not. So those two collections are housed in Contendium. I think most of you know about the Contendium. That is widely one of the widely used digital asset management tools. So Motley collection was created in 2009, and Portrait of Actors collection was created in 2012, both by the dedicated curators at our rare book and manuscript library. And the metadata for these two collections were also created by these two dedicated and very knowledgeable curators. That's why we chose these two collections. And this is a default image display page. So if it is a single item, Contendium displays image first and then associated metadata below the image. And if you look at the metadata, it seems like it is a very clean cut. So you can see that it is very simple, straightforward, and we kind of think that, well, we can work on it. But if you look at the metadata closely, it is not that simple. It describes many different things. What kind of things? For example, it describes the visual resource itself about the item that we digitized. And the metadata also describes about the performance that this specific item was used. For example, performance title, theater, and opening performance date, and production note. And lastly, it describes the work that performance was adapted from. So it has a performance title with also or composer that works were created. So we divided those three different categories into schemata or classes. And we come up with these three classes from schema.org. So we can have schema visual artworks. And then from schema is part of, they can be linked out to creative works. We want to use a stage work for the performance part. But at that time, the schema book doesn't have a subclass of creative works for stage work. But we are hoping that they would like to adopt these new subclasses under creative work. And then stage work is related to schema book by using example of works. So there are three classes of objects described by one single flat metadata for our image collections. So this is a representation of the JSON LD in these three different categories. So what have we learned for this one? It took us actually 6 months to whole process from analyzing metadata, cleanup, enrichment, and so on. And we realized that when you look at the metadata, it looks really simple and flat structure. But if you look at closely, the metadata describes more than one object. Without knowing that, we would like to put a lot of information into one single metadata. So in the end, we have three different classes for schema.org. And the elements name include very different contextual information, very specific contextual information that should be actually changed into something different that the schema.org properties can appropriately describe. And the multiple values are added in one single element with different parentheses with specific qualifier like roles. So one of the elements that we have in Motley collection is associated people. That is about every people performed for that specific performance. So person's name is described with parentheses like a director, a producer, or actor, and so on. So we have to divide all those things separately. And then because it is a special collections, it uses specialized local controlled vocabularies that we cannot find from already established libraries, controlled vocabularies, or authority data. So that is really interesting. And then we realized that we call those collections special collections in rare book or manuscript library or archives or maps or collections and so on. And the reason that we call special collections because the metadata is very special. So they need special care and attention when you work with linked data. So the second one, the Kohlprust archives collection is not an not exception. It is really headache things. So this is a card that we worked on. So you can see that all those cards has the main context. And then Professor Kolb added a lot of annotations and notes onto the card. So this one, actually one of our curators who is a French native, who studied, her research area is also Marcel Proust, and she worked this collection for more than 10 years. And she's the one who included this note card into TI. So we kind of trust that this collection is a perfect example for us to test the text-based special collections. Well, so the curators encoded those cards into TI documents at the time. We actually don't know why TI was chosen at the time, but she really painstakingly encode those note cards into TI. And then for the user interface, we transform those TI metadata into TI encoded documents into Doublinco. And by using XDF, we provide this kind of user interface. People can search and browse. And the facet services are provided in three different areas, the preferred name, date, and type. So for the mapping from TI elements to schema.org is really, really difficult. We met for almost two months of time every week to think about where to map TI elements to schema.org things. So we considered event could be the right one for the chronology, or it should be just the creative works for every card. But in the end, we settled into data set, because in the end, this is a note, research note card for Professor Philip Cole. So every card is mapped to schema data set, and every card as Professor Philip Cole as an author as a default value. And we use temporal coverage, mentions, and citation for very specific TI elements for the schema.org. And we also learned that our curator manages name databases separately to make all the names should be consistently added into TI documents. And that name database, it is database, but it is in Excel spreadsheet, and that Excel spreadsheet is in three different columns. One is full name, second one is key code, and third one is info. So full name is just full name, last name, comma, first name. And the key code is used for TI documents. So when there is any name is appeared in the card, then our curator added this key code into TI documents that represent personal name. And the info is kind of really the gold mine for us. We look at those information carefully. It has so many different kind of information added into this column. You can see the birth date, death date, and the professional professions or family relationships, or even so friends' names are included in this column. Not every name has this rich information, but many of them has some kind of information added into info column. So we looked at the schema person classes very carefully, and then identified these 13 properties that we can use to take out very specific information from info and put it into the schema.org properties. So for example, if you would like to the information edited in info for .NET 6, we can have this kind of graph. So you can see very clearly type, this one is the, well, of course, person, and the gender of this person, and birth date, death date, children, and spouse, and so on. So this is later we used as a visualization of the people and the relationship between the families and so on. So what have we learned for mapping challenges, mapping for special collections? Still, there is a target vocabulary still missing some key entities. So specifically, no way to differentiate the production of a play from the individual performances that we would like to really clearly mention in our linked data outcome. And they can be actually solved by locally extending schemas. But if you, people talk about a lot of interoperabilities, but where can you find the local extensions if it is not published in the community? And the many entities are not currently listed in linked data sources because it is a very special collections. So for call proofs, we assigned URIs to every name and then linked the ones listed in authority-controlled database to those databases. So we could do these kind of things to Motley or the portrait of actors as well, but we are not sure whether that is the best way at this point. So we should we give every names just our local URIs and wait until somebody else created authority data other places? We are not quite sure that point at this point. And then we also learned that metadata enrichment and reconciliation work is really, really necessary step for digitized special collections. For the Motley collection, we did a very detailed and hands-on metadata cleanup workflows. So we export metadata from ContentDM in its original form, and then look at the elements' names and the values at the same time. Not just the elements, but the values added in the metadata elements. And we added granularity to elements' names. So if the elements' name means more than one meaning, then we divided it into separate elements. And if the values added in the metadata has several things that should be separated into different different elements or repeated elements, then we did that at this point. And then next, we identify and perform metadata enhancement and reconciliation work with linked data sources and authority data. And for this part, we not only consulted with traditional libraries, authority data, or linked data services, but also the theater-based things. For example, Theatricalia or internet movie database and internet Broadway database and so on. Because library data, library authority data and linked data doesn't fully cover the specialized collections at this point. And the last part of our metadata workflow is mapping these local elements to schema.org properties and classes and ingested into the system. And the end product of our work is HTML plus JSON-LD representation of our data. So these are the sources that we consulted in manual process. The sources supporting linked data is already well known in the library community. And the other web resources are found, identified by our graduate assistant who works diligently for 6 months to find every detail about the names or entities mentioned in our metadata. So metadata for the metadata enrichment, we try to provide linking or canonical URIs for all those different entities, persons, venues, place, subject headings, and bibliographic entities. And again, the manual process really, really helps us to find URIs for those names, entities. So for example, person URIs found through manual process, it is really a lot of, it helps a lot of the recall rates. So total persons identified in Motley metadata is 984, and the links have been found for 624. And among 624, 106 links were found only by manual process, and 364 names were found through automatic way, and 112 were found both processes. So you can see that how important it is for the manual process in terms of finding URIs for special collections. And one of the things that I would like to point out is the matching the URIs found from Theatricalia, that is the web resource, but not support linked data. But since it is for very specific theater-based resources, we have a lot of success to find those names from this specific resource. So I have 1 minute, so I will go through fast. So we are kind of, these are the kind of things that we found. So additional name authority sources are needed for special collections. Libraries' traditional authority data and linked data services are not sufficient enough for digitized special collections. And when searching manually for entity links, we found that WorldCat identity has a really good first place you have to explore. And Google web search is the next. But when you use Google, we all know that the name and birth date as date is not enough. You have to have a very, very specific keyword for this specific the person. And the manual cleanup of metadata and manual search helps really, really important for digitized special collections. And then, what's the benefit of this linked data? We would like to make our collections as discoverable by web. So this is the Google structured data testing tool. So JSON-LD is understanding correctly for our Google. So by using a JavaScript web widget, we decide to create a sidebar with entities that has external links. So for example, if you are searching for visual artwork, then you can see that what the information about the material collection as well as external links. And then venues, performance and venues entities, you can see the theater names with a lot of with very short descriptions and external link as well. And then if the people associated in metadata have links, then you can see all those names, information about the names from the sidebar that we recently put it into user interface. And then, work in progress, because we would like to find more things that we can do with linked data. The first thing is pushing out and pushing back in. So we are not only creating articles for Wikipedia, but also adding our collection and item link into Wikipedia articles that are related with other our resources. And the next one is data visualization. About the names databases that we have, we try to create the data visualization for named databases. So you can search those names, and then if you click those names, then you can see how many card has that specific names. And then this one is between families, when those two families have correspondence each other. So this is Dodet family and Han family. They have corresponded 27 times in from 1910 to 1900 to 1910. So you can see those relations, social relationships by visualization. And people talk about annotation, and we would like to also implement those annotation services into our web pages, a visualization tool as well. And lastly, we would like to create a knowledge card with all those external links that we find from URIs. So when users are searching specific names, then we not only display those items related that has metadata. The metadata contains the specific names. We created a knowledge card about the person, so people can see their face, and then shoot biography and external links and associated people and so on. So people don't need to go out to find out more information about those entities and so on. So and this is the last slide. We think that there is additional opportunities for leveraging the semantic web, and we really have to work together to find new ways to work with linked open data for digitized special collections. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, MJ. So is there any questions? It's always hard because now people are longing for lunch.
Maybe it's too fast.
Yeah. So I was wondering, for the schema.org data, so you have published them already? Or in terms of feedback, did you get already feedback on
it? We don't actually publish those things. We put it into our triple store and then used as creating that sidebar and bring those information outside from the web services. But we don't publish it yet as, yes.
Okay, so you consume it within your own services.
Yes, it's just the service point for our service, yes.
Yeah, okay. Oh, there is a question at the...
I'm also working with performing arts data, so I saw a lot of things that I see in my daily life as well. Thank you for your talk. I have a tip maybe on the productions for you, because in Wikidata, there are a lot of productions coming up now, like people trying to catalog productions there, kind of. So maybe you should check that one out, because you get identifiers there a lot. Yes. At least I use that now for that. Yes. There's also a Wikidata project going on from the Swiss Theatre Library, which is also really interesting ontology and vocabulary like. And yeah, I don't think they use schema.org, but that's also a very interesting ontology to use, maybe. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions? No? Okay, so now we have the lunch break. Thank you very much.